What if you are part of an organization as a network administrator and you are given a task to assign IP addresses to your company devices? Your task is to assign IP addresses for 5 different departments: HR department, IT department, accounting department, boss department, and call center agent department. Your senior network administrator gave you a subnetted IP address for those 5 different departments of 206.21.5.0 with a subnet mask of 255.255.255.224. Ngayon ang tanong, ano-anong IP addresses ang ibibigay natin sa kada department para sila mapunta sa iba't ibang network? After subnetting your network, you need to identify your subnet ID or the network address. We have 4 steps in identifying your subnet IDs or the network address. Number 1 is convert your subnet mask into binary. Number 2, determine the increment. Number 3, determine your subnet 0. And lastly, add your increment. We have an IP address of 206.21.5.0 na binigay sa atin ng network admin natin. And it is already subnetted into 255.255.255.224 para ma-comply yung 5 network requirement. And now, para ma-achieve natin yun, we must determine the subnet IDs. The first step is to convert your subnet mask into binary. So, i-convert natin itong dati decimal format natin na subnet mask into binary. So, pag kinonvert natin yan, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then, yung 224, paano natin makukuha yan? So, 128 plus 64 and plus 32. And it will make 224. So, the rest is 0. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, ito yung subnet mask natin into binary. Next step is to determine the increment. Ang increment natin ay yung pinakahuling 1 sa subnet mask natin, which is this one. Then, we must get the value. Anong value ba nitong 1 na ito? Paano ulit natin malalaman? Gagamitin natin yung table natin. So, yan ay pangatlo. 1, 2, 3. Bali, ang value ng increment natin ay 32. So, ganun lang siya kasimple. 32 ang increment natin. Ano nga ba ang subnet 0? Ang subnet 0 is the first subnet after doing the subnetting. And our first subnet or our subnet 0 is this one. So, 206.21.5.0. So, this is our first subnet or the subnet 0. After determining our subnet 0, we must now do the last step, which is the add your increment. So, ano nga ulit ang increment natin? Our increment is 32. Saan natin i-add ang increment? We will add our increment in our subnet 0, which is 206.21.5.0. Now, saan natin i-add yung 32? Sa 206? Sa 21? Sa 5 ba? Or sa 0? Para ma-determine natin saan natin i-add yung increment natin na 32, aalamin lang natin or tatanungin natin yung sarili natin, saan ba tayo nang hiram ng host portion natin? Tayo ay nanghiram ng host portion sa 4th octet, which is this one. Nanghiram tayo sa 4th octet. Now, sa 4th octet din tayo mag-a-add ng increment natin. Paano natin gagawin yun? 206.21.5 sa 4th octet tayo mag-a-add. So, 0 plus 32 ay .32. Now, this is our first subnet ID. Paano natin makukuha yung second subnet ID natin? Makukuha natin yan, just add the 32. So, 206.21.5.32 plus 32 is 64. So, this is our second subnet ID. Next is 206.21.5.64 plus 32 is 96. So, this is our third subnet ID. Next is 206.21.5. 96 plus 32 is 128. So this is our fourth subnet ID. Next is 206.21.5. 128 plus 32 is 160. So this is our fifth subnet ID. Next is 206.21.5.160 plus 32 is 192. So this is our sixth subnet ID. Next is 206.21.5.192 plus 32 is 224. So this is our seventh subnet ID. So 206.21.5.224 plus 32 is 256. Now, question. 256. Kung i-recall natin yung knowledge natin about IP addressing, hanggang 255 lang ang maximum natin. Tama po ba? Kasi kung i-add natin itong table na to, i-add natin lahat yan. 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. 255. Which means, hanggang 255 lang dapat tayo. Anong ibig sabihin nun? Hindi valid ang 256. So, paano ang dapat nating gawin? Sa decimal na numbering system natin, ang number natin ay 0 to 9 lamang. So, kung meron tayong 9, then magdadagdag tayo ng 1, 9 plus 1, we will have 0 and we will carry 1 doon sa kabila to make it 1, 0, or 10. Sa IP address natin, we have 0 up to 255. So, kung meron tayong number na 255 plus 1, 255 plus 1 is equals to 0 carry 1. Bakit nga ba 0 carry 1 ang sagot? Since hanggang 255 nga lang ang number natin. So, babalik tayo ngayon ulit sa 0 and magki-carry 1 na lang tayo doon sa susunod na number natin. So, kung i-apply natin yan dito sa IP address natin, instead of 256, dapat ito ay 0, then carry 1 sa susunod na number. 5 plus 1 is 6. So, ang sagot is 206.21.6.0. This is our subnet ID. And per subnet ID is equal to 1 network. So, anong ibig sabihin nun? Kada subnet ID na ito ay isa siyang network. So, pwede natin i-alat itong network na to sa HR department. Then, i-alat natin itong network na to sa IT department. Then, i-alat natin ito sa accounting department. And, i-alat natin ito para kay boss, sa department ni boss. And, i-alat natin ito para sa ating mga call center agent department. So, now we successfully divided into different networks yung kada department natin. My question is, kasama pa ba sa network natin itong 206.21.6.0? Paano natin malalaman hanggang saan yung sakop ng subnetwork natin? Malalaman natin yun, i-determine lang natin ilang bits ulit ang nireserve natin para sa network. 3 bits. So, 3 bits. So, 1, 2, 3. So, kung i-add natin itong tatlo, 4 plus 2 is 6, plus 1 is 7. Ibig sabihin, we can have 7 subnetworks. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ibig sabihin, itong 206.21.6.0 is hindi na siya kabilang sa network natin. Because hanggang 7 subnetworks lamang ang nireserve natin sa ating subnet mask. Now, para mas mahasa pa tayo, let's have another exercise. Let's say we have a subnetted IP address of 192.168.1.0 and a subnet mask of 255.255.255.128. Now, let's try to determine the subnet IDs. So, kindly pause this video and try to solve this exercise. Thank you for pausing the video and for trying to solve this exercise. First step is convert your subnet mask into binary. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then, 128 is 1, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now this is our binary. Next is to determine the increment. The increment is this one. So this one is 128. So our increment is 128. Next process is determine your subnet 0. Our subnet 0 is 192.168.1.0, 192.168.1.0. Last process is to add your increment, which is 128. Now, the question is, saan natin i-add yung increment natin? I-add natin yan sa ating fourth octet, kasi sa fourth octet tayo nanghiram or nag-reserve ng bits sa network natin. Our first subnet ID is 192.168.1.0 plus 128 is 128. Then 192.168.1.128 plus 128 is 256. 256 is not valid, so dapat siya ay 0, then carry 1 to make it 2. 192.168.2.0. Now, hanggang saan ang sakop ng network natin? Nag-reserve tayo ng 1 bit para sa network natin. So, 1 bit is equals to 1. So, we can create 1 subnet. So, ito yung subnet natin. So, which means, itong 192.168.2.0 is from another network. So, ang network lang natin ay from 192.168.1.0, which is our subnet 0, and 192.168.1.128. And this IP address is from another network. So, kung yan ang sagot nyo, ay congratulations, tama po ang inyong sagot. Ngayon, para sa susunod nating exercise, what if uses class B IP address? We have an IP address of 172.16.0.0 and a subnet mask of 255.255.192.0. Now, try to solve this problem and kindly pause this video. Salamat sa pag-pause ng video na ito at pag-try i-solve yung problem natin. For the first step, we must convert our subnet mask into binary. So, let's convert 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then, we have 192. So, 192 in binary is 1, 1. Then, the rest is 0, 2, 3, 4. Then, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, this is our subnet mask in binary. Next step is to determine the increment. Our increment is this one. Ano nga ba itong number na to? 1, 2. So, our increment is 64. Next step is to determine your subnet 0. Your subnet 0 is 172.16.0.0. Last step is to add your increment sa subnet 0 natin. The question is, saan tayo mag-a-add ng increment? Again, mag-a-add tayo ng increment kung saan tayo nag-reserve ng bits sa network natin. Nag-reserve tayo sa ating third octet. Tayo ay mag-a-add ng increment sa third octet ng subnet 0 natin. So, paano yun? 172.16.0 plus 64 is 64.0. So, this is our first subnet ID. Next is 172.16.64 plus 64 is 128.0. Next is 172.16.128 plus 64 is 192.0. Next is 172.16.192 plus 64 is 256. That is invalid. 0, carry 1 to make it 17. 0.0. So, our subnet IDs are 172.16.64.128.192. The question is, hanggang saan yung network natin? So, we reserve 2 bits. 1, 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. So, we can create 3 subnetworks. So, 1, 2, 3. So, ito lang ang sakop ng ating subnetwork. This IP address is from another network. Hindi natin siya ka-network. If this is your answer, congratulations, nakuha na natin kung paano ba mag-determine ng subnet ID natin. In this video, we learn how to determine our subnet IDs as well as the subnet 0. we define subnet 0 as the first subnet after subnetting. And as per old subnetting rules, you cannot use the first subnet as well as the last subnet. But this first and last subnet can be used if you configure the command IP subnet 0. But wherever possible, don't use this subnet 0 because old protocols such as RIP and IGRP cannot handle 0 subnet.
I hope that this has been educative for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching. And if you're new to this channel, please don't forget to click the subscribe and bell button. So paano? Hanggang dito na lang tayo. Kita-kita na lang tayo sa mga susunod pa nating mga video.